And so now we start our conversation with the different guests, and I'm calling Hoor Ahli, a delegate from the Youth4Climate COP from the United Arab Emirates. Welcome, Hoor. You can stay there. It's really a pleasure to welcome one of the delegates from the Youth4Climate. We know it's a novelty. It's been an event where many of us have been following these days to see how you were working, what was coming out of there. Of course, for the past few years, we've been looking with a huge interest to the crowds of young people around the world who have been finally, I have to say, moving us as well to become more aware of the big issue of the climate crisis and its consequences for the entire world. So, Hoor, first of all, how was the atmosphere? You're just like almost at the end of it. How was this particular event for you?
So today was the end, we can say, of Youth4Climate event, but definitely not the end of the action that's going to be done. And the atmosphere, to be honest, was more than amazing. I really, really loved it because, you know, it's people from all around the world, and you get to connect with them, to network with them, and just getting to hear about all these perspectives from all around the world is really fascinating, because usually we're in the UAE, we would, you know, hear about Gulf countries around us, but hearing people like talking to me from Africa, from other parts of Asia, from Europe, from America, it's just really nice, and I feel you can get a lot from it.
Can you tell us a little bit how you worked? Because we know you've been working in different working groups to draft this document. How did it go?
So there are four working groups, and I was in the second one, which is sustainable recovery, a huge field of interest of mine, and specifically in the subgroup of tourism. And I come from the UAE, from Dubai, and tourism is just a huge industry back there. So we had a lot to add on. We had a zero draft that we initially were doing edits on and adding to. So we were taking into consideration the developed countries, the developing countries, so that our proposal would be inclusive of all of you know, the countries that are going to be taking part in it.
And what do you think, I mean, in terms of the impact of the work you've been doing? Of course, this is a step. It's not, as you said, the final step. It's actually a very important step, but looking forward, what kind of impact you think you might concretely have?
Like today, after hearing all the ministers that were there, the president was there, the prime minister as well, I think so much work is going to happen, and it's definitely the maybe beginning of change, because it added like a lot of value seeing the ministers being there from all around the world, because, you know, like them hearing us, listening to us, and engaging directly with us has added like so much, you know, empowerment plus motivation to go on, and that our voices are heard and something's going to happen.
Do you have the impression that you have enough connection with the science world on one side, the policy world on the other? I mean, do you get real support? Or I know these days we've been hearing a lot about the blah, blah, blah discussion about how much of this is the blah, 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 how much is actually concrete action from your point of view?
So I think for the most part, this is what we're going to see after the conference and like after what's going to happen, because we've got so many promises for many from like many leaders, and like hoping for the best in COP and even COP16 that's going to be in Glasgow.
Okay, so what's the next step for you now?
So now what I mainly want to do is go back to my country, tell them about all my insights, all of the things that I have seen, because we are working on, you know, putting out youth more in decision making on like a local or a national level. So with Expo as well going on, like many volunteers are there, and we can do a lot. Climate Week is coming up, and for sure our insights would be there, and the messages that we want to share would be communicated there.
One last question, and then we know she has to go back because she has a flight to catch, so a plane to catch. One of the things that you mentioned earlier was the importance also of, to understand, to become aware of the differences of the impact of the crisis in different countries. Do you think that, are we becoming more aware of these inequalities and differences of impact, or are we still have a lot to work to do to get there and to understand exactly what we should do moving forward?
So definitely there is a lot of work that has to be done, but we can see progress. For example, like just on talking about myself, I have, you know, seen these so many new perspectives that are like eye-opening, to be honest. And coming from, you know, a financially, we can say, stable country, talking to other people from developing countries that are really maybe have vulnerable communities, it is really nice to just have these conversations with them and talk about how differently we can view things. So I found it really interesting, and we are definitely on the way of a more of climate conscious society.
Thank you, Hoor Ahli, and we want to wish her a good flight back. So a safe trip back home, and we hope to see you again in one of the next opportunities for discussion.
For sure, looking forward to it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.